Hi there, it's Ruth at Artful Stamping, wanting to wish you a very, very happy Christmas. I filmed this ahead of time so that it can go live on Christmas Day, and so I hope you're enjoying whatever it is that you're doing today, whether it's with family or friends or just, being with people, or even being on your own. Some people like to spend Christmas on their own. So I'm going to be making a card that... I have had a little practice already making this. I'm just going to score my A4 sheet of cardstock at 9.5 centimetres. Or if you're doing this in inches, that's about 3¾ inches. And then at 19. And then I'm going to cut that off at 28.5, which is about 11¼ inches, and I'm wanting to make a bit of a nativity triptych. Okay, so I haven't actually measured this part out as yet, because what I want to do is have the card be able to fold in like so, but then I wanted to cut it from here. So I am going to score. At 5¾ inches, which is about 14.6 millimetres. I'm just going to put a little... Actually, I can cut it here if I want to. So I'm just going to cut it. And then just move it up over just a tiny notch and mark it at... Oh, will that be... ¼ centimetres. So that's about there. So that's halfway. I think it has marked it. I'm just going to pop a pencil mark there as well so that I can see it there. Okay, and then I want to put a little score mark at about... Oh, I know what, 4 inches. So it's either about 10 centimetres or 4 inches. So I know you can't see that, but I'm scoring at the bottom as well. And then I'm just going to line up that score mark at the side. With the mark here. Right, and cut. And then align up the middle there with the score that I've done at the bottom. Okay, there we have it. Sorry, that took a little bit longer than I intended to do. And then I'm going to be using, for the last time this year, the All You Faithful stamp set, which I actually already have out. Oh, there we go. There it is. Got another one there. And I'm going to be using the Archival Black ink pad, which I'm really enjoying using right now. It gives a really great finish. So I'm going to have my Mary, Joseph and Jesus in the centre there. And the fact that I'm sort of, well, I've been inspired by looking at some other nativity triptychs on Pinterest. I remember learning about them as a child. I was home educated until I was about 9, and part of the syllabus that my parents followed was looking at different art pieces of art, and we learned about a triptych, which is basically a painting in three parts, and usually they're constructed so that they can actually fold in like that. So yeah, right, I'm just going to close this up for now, and I have already pre-cut on some sticky note a mask already, so I'm just going to place those on and then come back to you. Okay, so I've placed my masks on, and I'm going to just do a little bit of stamping before I'm going to do a lot of sponging on the background here. So I'm using the kind of Sunburst from Kinda Eclectic, and I'm going to aim the centre of that over where the baby Jesus is there. So. And then you may have seen me do this technique on my flowers before, but I'm actually going to lift the stamp up a little bit and twist it, and then re-stamp, and then twist, and re-stamp. You only have to move it very, very slightly to get the effect. Okay, so what you end up is with this kind of like slightly hazed effect around there. Okay, so then I'm going to get the Stampin' Up sponge. I don't know why I'm starting with yellow. I need to start with green, actually. Oh, no, I will start with yellow. It's best to do light first. I'm just going to sponge a little bit more around the actual figures. And then we're going to carry this yellow through right across the card here. So I'm just putting my fingers out to hold on to the masking so that it doesn't lift up and so I don't get ink. And I'm brushing kind of away because the sticky area of the sticky notes are sort of across the bottom. So I'm sort of brushing gently so that I don't lift it up too much. And then I want some yellow across here. Okay, the next colour I'm using is Garden Green, and I want this across the sort of base of the card here. Now, the thing about sponging is, or using any inks to paper, is that after it dries a little bit, it does sort of change a little bit about how it looks. So just try and go slow and just add the colour gradually and build it up gently. I'm going a little bit too fast really, but so that I can get this filmed, but when you're doing this yourself you can take your time a little bit more than I am. Okay, so I'm just going to add a little bit of Island Indigo. So I'm just trying to darken up the base here. Oh, I've just noticed I've got some ink on there, but never mind. Hopefully when I put this red on it, I'll cover it up. Okay, so I'm just adding a little bit of Cherry Cobbler now to the layer up here. Okay, so that's the Cherry Cobbler. The reason I've gone for quite rich, kind of vibrant colours is because I was inspired by the look that stained glass windows tend to have in churches. So they tend to be very rich, bold colours. So this is now a Perfect Plum, just making it slightly darker at the top here. Okay, and now we're going to just put a little bit more of the Island Indigo at the top just to draw that colour or the whole look together of having the Island Indigo at the top and the bottom. Although it is mixing quite beautifully with the purple, it's not very noticeable that it's Island Indigo anymore. Okay, right, so that's the colour done. So now I'm going to bring back the black ink pad, and I'm going to be using a new product that's going to be available during Celebration next year, And it's this beautiful floral stamp set here called Flowering Fields. And I just love the kind of the way they've been drawn. They're really beautiful. Very simple line drawings. And that's kind of the effect I wanted in the background, because I want to do quite a lot of repeat pattern with the black. So I have tested this out before, but I did it on a smaller card. So I'm going to see how it turns out. So you'll just have to bear with me and just enjoy the process. I want to just stamp some flowers here, but I don't want the stem to come all the way down because I'm going to be putting some other flowers there. So I'm just using a post-it note to mask off the area there. And I want to bring in these leaves here. Carry on these leaves across the middle. Over to the shepherd now. And then carry on with some more elements. Okay, I think I've finished doing all the ones that I want to do across the bottom. I'm just going to turn it around because I want to have some leaves coming down from the top. Right, I think I'm going to leave it there for the stamping. So all that remains for me to do is to remove the masks. And I have experimented before with colouring in these images. And I think it just makes it look a bit too overpowering and you can't really see what's going on. So I'm going to leave them white. However, I'm going to be using a little bit of this Wink of Stella, which again is going to be available from January in the new catalogue. And this is the silver option. And I'm just going to add some glitter elements to the crowns of the Magi and their gifts to Jesus. And then maybe around baby Jesus. Maybe just with the tops of the clothes. I And we're going to be, well, remembering the Magi and the gifts they brought Jesus. And I've been reflecting on the gifts that they brought and how they were so apt for a king. But not just that, the gold was for the king. And the frankincense was given because he was going to be a priest, and the myrrh because he was then eventually going to be sacrifice. So there's just such wonderful significance in those gifts that were brought to the child Jesus. Because in actual fact, I don't think he was a baby when the Magi came. He was probably about 2 years old. But there we go, for the sake of this card, the Magi are coming to the baby Jesus. Okay, so then it was going to fold up, and obviously you can decorate the back of it or mount it onto something else, but I think I'm going to end my video there and say goodbye and a very happy Christmas to you. Bye.